The operators of a Turkish coal mine, where at least 284 people were killed, are denying accusations of negligence. The country's energy ministry says there may be as many as 18 miners still trapped underground. And now we are seeing clashes between protesters and police in Soma. Ivan Watson is there and he joins us now live. Ivan, what can you report?
Police have intervened, firing tear gas, firing water cannons, and plastic pellets at several thousand demonstrators who gathered in this city just 4 days after nearly 300 coal miners were killed in a mountain a few kilometers away from where we're standing right now. It's been an incredible scene as demonstrators have chanted, "Don't forget our dead, don't sleep, Soma. Have incredibly intervened. Right now it's in a lull. They've been chasing demonstrators who wore black through the streets of this small town. I saw one man injured, knocked unconscious after the water cannon went off. There is unbelievable anger from some of the people that the police would use force against a community in mourning from the worst mining disaster in Turkish city history. They are still burying the dead. They are still looking for the miners. And the Turkish police have been firing tear gas in the streets in the center of this small city against demonstrators wearing black as a symbol of mourning for the hundreds of workers killed, many of whom owned and earned the equivalent of $500 US a month. Becky.
Ivan, I know that you were at the mine very soon after these explosions. You were reporting as bodies were being pulled out of that shaft. Is there any hope for those still left in the mine?
It depends on who you talk to. If you speak with the rescue workers, they are praying, of course, that they can find survivors. Actual miners who've worked in there, they say there is little to no chance at all. Family members as well that I've spoken with feel that there is no chance that more survivors will come out. And we've learned from the managers of the coal mining company, Soma Holding Company, that they did not have a safe room at the deepest part of the coal mine where people were working. They had shut down one safe room and were in the process of planning to build another one. So one of the places where people could considerably have stayed alive is not an option for some kind of miracle rescue at this point. And this has moved on as hundreds of families are mourning this death, these deaths that have swept through this town and surrounding mining towns. Now you have the scenes of the police. Right now it has gotten calm. I was just choking gas that was being fired into balconies of the surrounding houses.